said that they were partners. Anna says maybe he was Luke. But they didn't confirm who was that person. But the one we know in the Bible is Cleopas. And those brothers, where did they come from? They were coming from Jerusalem and they were also disciples of Jesus. So they were in Jerusalem since the beginning of the crucifixion of Jesus. When he was crucified, all the disciples were there. Because Jesus invited them to go to Jerusalem. And in Jerusalem is where I will die. And everyone was like, okay, that's true, let's go. I know one of you guys will betray me. But they went, all of them, all the disciples. From those 12, and Jesus had some more disciples apart from those 12. And the Bible says it happened to them that he sent 70 disciples. And from those 12, Cleopas is not among them. Maybe it can be is one of those 70 or more than 70. The day of Pentecost were 120. Those were present when the Holy Spirit came from heaven. But all of those who were at the mountain were 600. I just want to show that they were a lot. And probably Cleopas was among them. But the Bible knew him. And participated in the crucifixion of Jesus. And they participated in the death of Jesus. When they saw Jesus die, and Jesus told them, I will rise after 3 days. And he told them that I'm gonna rise after 3 days. And Peter were there to cool them down that, okay, our Lord is going to raise after 3 days. And that Friday night, and they were in the house praying. And when they reached Saturday, Sunday morning, they knew that he is rose today. And the Bible says that the women were the first one to go to the town because they knew that Jesus is going to rise today, Sunday. But when they go, they didn't see anything. But they got angels there and asked the angel, asked them, who are you looking for? Are you looking for someone who is alive? Why are you looking someone alive from the death? Praise Lord. We are not talking about the resurrection of Jesus. But the angel told them that that person is alive. And he is in Galilee. And those disciples go back. So, when they got back, maybe they went to Peter and told them about all the stories that happened to the town. And the angel said that he is alive. So, all the disciples those news that rose from Peter and all disciples and they just found those stuff that covered the death But in the terms there was nothing.
Wakarudi.
So go back.
Waliporudi.
When they got back, all the disciples knew that Jesus is alive. And Cleopas and his friends. And the evening after they knew that Jesus is alive, let's go home. They were going home. In their way to home, when they were talking, they were talking about the death of Jesus. And I said that we're going to describe the way to Emmaus. And from these verses, we're going to describe one way to another. And just look which way can help you. The one that can help you, maybe this way can help you, but doesn't help the other person. It can help the other person, but doesn't help the other one. Why? It's on the Holy Spirit who know my weakness. He will give me what is important for me. So please follow.
Tutaona kwa nini Yesu alionekana kwa wale wa jamaa Cleopas na yule mwingine.
So we're gonna see why Jesus appeared to Cleopas and the other person. Why Jesus appeared to them?
Ingawaje wakumjua lakini sababu gani alionekana
kwao? Although they didn't recognize him, why did he appear to them?
Ni kwa sababu tu walikuwa wanafunzi wake.
Is it because just because the disciples of Jesus? Why did it he appear to those who stayed in Jerusalem? When they left Jerusalem to go back to Jerusalem, Peter and the other disciples stayed in Jerusalem waiting for the Holy Spirit. And they haven't seen Jesus, never. When those people went there, we're going to read to that place. When they asked him that, okay, it is almost now, please stay with us. And Jesus agreed to get to the house. When he get with them the house, they brought food. They brought food as normal. And Jesus blessed the bread. After blessing the bread, their eyes were opened. And they realized that, oh, surely it was Jesus we talked with. And they said, why her heart didn't open? And all of them stood up and went back to
Jerusalem.
When they reached Jerusalem, and told to Peter that we saw Jesus. After they informed the Peter that they saw Jesus, and Jesus appeared among them and said, peace with all of you. Praise the Lord. That word, let us describe it a
little bit.
We might go fast, but please follow carefully. The first thing that that's where Jesus appeared to those disciples. Because they were talking about the death of Jesus and the persecution of Jesus before he arose from the dead.
Yani hawakuwa na mada nyingine.
That means they didn't have another topic. The only topic they were talking about was about the death of Jesus. Why did they kill them? He was gentle, he was our hope, he was powerful. Maybe if he was the king, he could deliver us from his kingdom. That's what the Bible says here. The Bible says that they thought Jesus would redeem them from the kingdom of Romans.
Mazungumzo mazuri.
That means the better accommodation. The better accommodation is what made Jesus appear to them. If they were talking about bad
condition,
I don't believe Jesus would appear to them. If they were talking about the other people, I don't believe Jesus would have appeared to them. But because the condition was first apparent, they were remembering the death of Jesus, the way he died and the way he resurrected. That's why Jesus appears to them. You can have a look on verse
14.
And they were talking one to another the news of Jesus that appeared.
Ikawa katika kuzungumza na kuulizana kwao,
and the way they were talking and asking one another,
Yesu mwenyewe aliwakaribia.
Jesus himself approached them.
Akaandamana nao.
And he took the way along with them.
La kwanza ambalo linafanya Yesu kuonekana katika maisha yetu.
So the same thing that made Jesus to appear in our life.
Mazungumzo mazuri.
The good condition.
Katika mazungumzo mazuri.
In the good condition.
Inavuta baraka za Mungu.
It attracts the blessing of God.
Inavuta Mungu mwenyewe kuwa pamoja nao.
It attracts God to be with you.
Inavuta Yesu mwenyewe kuonekana kwako.
It attracts Jesus to appear to you.
Lakini kama uzungumze mazuri, hauna mazungumzo mazuri.
But if you don't have a good condition.
Ikiwa hauzungumze mazungumzo mazuri.
If you don't talk about good things. Instead of Jesus coming to you, there is another servant who will come close to you. If it was talking bad to people, you're going to see the anger coming to you. Why? Because there is some other thing that is pushing that thing. Because your confession is related to your stuff. When you feel that condition, all of you guys will be mad. And you will be, I don't want to cooperate with them. Why?
Ulikuwa umezungumza mazungumzo mabaya.
Because you were in bad condition.
Mapepo ya shetani ndio yalikuwa yanakupuliza ili uendelee kuwaka na hasira.
And the demons from the evil was the one that was getting you to get angry. So when you are talking about good condition,
Yesu naye atakukaribia.
Jesus will come close to you. And you will feel joy in your heart. Even if you were sad, you will see like some happiness coming and some blessing coming upon you because you were in a good condition. So yourself, wherever you sit down, what kind of condition are you talking about? If you sit with your partner or your friend, what kind of condition are you taking? Are you talking about the devil coming in your life? Or are you talking about the way of Jesus so Jesus can come to you? Please have good condition. The second thing that made Jesus to appear to them, they were concerned about Jesus. So if you read all the stories, you will find out that they didn't know that it was Jesus. So to be concerned with someone,
ni hisi kwamba unahusika na mtu yule ama na kile kitu, yani unahusika na yeye.
That means to care someone, that means you are concerned and you have some interest in that person.
Kumjali mtu ile ni kama unamtia maanani, unamweka kama ni mtu ambaye ni wa muhimu sana.
To be concerned or to care someone, that means you value that person and you seem like some person values you.
Watu kabisa pamoja na uzuni wao, lakini hawakumsahau yule bwana ambaye walikuwa naye.
So all those people although they were sad, but they didn't dismiss that person.
Walimtia maanani, waliona kwamba na yeye ni wa muhimu katika msafara wetu, twende tu.
So they were concerned about that person and they saw him like someone brother that we can share the road with. So they saw him like some person who is valued to them. To take care of someone. So to care about someone doesn't need your race. That this one is black or white. Or is my brother, or is someone from my family, or not? Maybe this person is young or adult, I don't care about him. To care about someone, that means everyone, you see, everyone is important to you. So there are some people, when they get used to one another, they don't care about that person. We will find that there is some kind of negligence among
them.
So you will find even in some households, like husband and wife, they don't have the same respect they used to be. So the habit reduced that respect. But the Bible doesn't say that. The Bible says you should obey your husband at the head of the house. And you should love your wife just like Jesus loved the church. The Bible says that when you have five children, you should disobey them. Maybe because he has black or white hairs, so you misjudge him and tell him to young people. The Bible doesn't say that. The Bible says you should love. Because Jesus loved us until the end of your life. Praise Lord. That means to take to care about someone. You see him like some person who value to you. That person has value to me. Cleopas and his friends, they were concerned about Jesus. So do you care about anyone? Or you just care about the people you live with? If they didn't care about Jesus, he wouldn't appear to them. That's the third thing. He wouldn't tell them what all the stuff that happened there. The second thing, he wouldn't stay with them in all that night. But because they care about him, he told them about a lot of things. You can undermine a kid, but he's an angel. Maybe he or she may have a word that has been sent by God to tell you.
So
don't undermine the young people. One day my kid told me, and he told me that, mother, I saw an angel at the door. She didn't know that who is an angel, but said, I met with an angel at the door of my room. And he went there so we could see the angel. And said, oh, I saw the angel here. Have you ever seen the angel? But those young people, they see angels. That means you should also care about the young people. Those are very important in the kingdom of Jesus. Praise God. You should put everyone with his own value. You should take everyone as a valued person. That person can help me. Not only the people from my family. That means everyone can help you. And everyone can be used by God. The third thing, Jesus to appear to those people.
Walikuwa na huzuni ya kifo cha Yesu.
They were sad about the death of Jesus.
Na ndio maana Cleopa alimtibu yule mtu vile.
That's why Cleopas answered that person that way. So we can read verse 18.
Akajibu mmoja wao.
And one of them answered.
Jina lake Cleopa.
Whose name was Cleopas.
Akamwambia.
And said,
Je, wewe peke yako ungeni ungeni katika Yerusalem?
Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem?
Hata uyajue yaliyotukia humu siku hizi.
Who does not know the things that have taken place there in these days?
Unaona? Je, wewe huku mgeni hapa Dayton? Wewe huku.
So if they ask you, are you stranger in Dayton?
Aya mbaya nikitika hapa Dayton, wewe hayajui.
You don't know the stuff that happened then? I don't think that person can talk with happiness. Like, are you the stranger dating? Do you think that one can come with joy? Are you the stranger here in dating? That's where it no, doesn't have any value. But if someone talk like, are you stranger dating? The stuff that happened dating, are you stranger here? That things that when is coming from sadness. That's why Jesus asked, what happened here? That means Cleopas talked with all sadness. The sadness was about the death of Jesus. And another person is coming just asking around. And replied, oh, are you stranger here? And maybe that a person will push him away, but they didn't touch him. They just told him, oh, are you a stranger here? That's where they stopped. And Jesus said, what happened here? And they started telling him the story. And you can read there, it continues. And at verse 19, they started telling him what happened. So we had a gentle person that was called Jesus of Nazareth. And that person was talking the word in the, from the power of God. Yeah, the power of God. And we believe we will redeem her from this kingdom. And Cleopas was telling the story that has happened. But he was here, but they killed him. So you can also read the Bible when you receive this story. And some women from us went to the tomb and they didn't find anything. And we don't know where he goes. And Jesus saw inside them that these people had sadness of losing him. And some people can ask themselves, why Cleopas asked it with anger? It was because of the sadness of losing Jesus. It's because they were concerned about Jesus. They believed in Jesus. Because they believed in Jesus, that's why they were sad. But what Jesus answered? And Jesus answered, you who are foolish with low heart of believing, and it is on 25, and with slow of what to believe. And Jesus started talking somewhere over there. And I'm asking you, you as Cleopas, do you take care of Jesus? Do you keep your hope in Jesus?
matumaini yako yote kwa Yesu?
Do you put your hope, all your hope in Jesus?
Ya kwamba Yesu anaweza kukomboa katika utumwa wa dhambi?
That Jesus can save you from the slavery of sin?
Ama anaweza kukusaidia katika shida zako ama katika tatizo zako?
Or he can help you from your problem and troubles?
Biblia inasema ya kwamba tumwekee kwake Mungu matumaini yetu yote.
And the Bible says we should put all our hope in Jesus.
Kama tunamwekea matumaini yetu,
if we put all our hope in Jesus,
Yesu atakuwa pamoja nasi siku zote za maisha yetu.
Jesus will be with us in all our days.
Zaburi 125 inasema namna gani?
That's why in Psalm 125.
Bwana ni kama mlima Sayuni.
So those who believe in Jesus are just like the Mount of Zion. Just like the mounts around Jerusalem. That's how God surrounds his own people. Those people keep their hope in Jesus. That's what Jesus said, that I'll be with you until the last day. It's for those people who keep their hope in Jesus. Those who are even here, those who put their hope in Jesus, they have Jesus. And those who do not put their hope in Jesus, they don't have Jesus. Because that's what the Bible says. We surround those who believe in Him. And there's nothing that can frighten them. Praise Lord. Let's keep on. Do you believe that we're gonna we live with Jesus within His kingdom of 1,000 years?
Bwana yetu atatawala.
Our Jesus will be there.
Hapa hapa.
And here.
Na hii kanisa itakuwa iko hapa.
And this church will be here.
Hii jengo tutakuwa tuko tena hapo si. Kama wewe utakuwa umebaki utakuwa iko hapa.
Maybe if you be here, this building will stay here.
Shetani anapewa utawala wa miaka 7.
And the devil has the kingdom of 7 years.
Lakini Yesu ana alijipatia utawala wa miaka 1,000.
But Jesus has the kingdom of 1,000 years.
Shetani atatawala baba.
And Judas, the devil will power is here.
Kilicho tofauti na Yesu.
And different from Jesus.
Tutakuwa tunamuona ni huyu.
We will see Jesus.
Na watu wote watakuwa wanamuona huyu.
And they will be seeing him like this is Jesus.
Lakini hata tawala kama yani hataonekana kama mtu.
But the devil won't cover like a human being.
Isipokuwa ile sanamu yake na wale watu wake na vio uongo wale watu wote ndio watakuwa wanaonekana.
But always the statues and all false prophets will be seen.
Tutatawala pamoja na Bwana wetu.
So we cover with Jesus.
Twende sasa tuchambue kile ambacho Yesu alisema.
Let's describe what Jesus said.
Yesu alisema enyi msio na ufahamu.
Jesus said, you who are foolish and we have a slow heart of believing,
tuko katika 25.
We are reading 25. Tunakwenda
kuteremka chini.
So we go further.
You msio na ufahamu.
I said, you who are foolish and with a slow heart of believing,
yote walio yasema manabii,
everything that the prophet said,
je, haikumpasa Kristo kupata mateso haya na kuingia katika utukufu wake?
Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then even in his glory?
Akaanza kutoka Musa mpaka manabii anawaambia wale wanafunzi wake.
Then beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them the things about himself. And when Jesus was talking,
na wakati ulikuwa unaendelea,
and the time was moving on.
Biblia hapa inatushauri namna gani kwa hili enyi msio na ufahamu?
And the Bible, what the Bible actually has here at 25 that says you are foolish.
Sisi wa Kristo tuwe na ufahamu wa kujua maneno ya Mungu.
The Bible says us as Christians we should have knowledge to know the way of God.
Hapana ufahamu wa kujua maneno yasiyofaa.
Not the knowledge of knowing the things that are obscene.
Ufahamu wa kuweka maneno ya Mungu ndani mwetu.
We should have the knowledge to keep the way of God inside of us.
Ndio maana alisema kwanza Biblia nyingine inasema enyi wapumbavu.
And other Bible says who are stupid.
Kwa sababu yeye anawaambia bwana mimi nitakufa.
Because Jesus said that I'm going to die.
Na kabla yeye hajasema vitabu vya Musa yeye akazaliwa na manabii walisema ya kwamba
and even before the birth the books from Moses and all the prophets say that he gonna die and will raise again.
Wakati yeye anaambia wanafunzi wake wote ya kwamba mimi nitakufa baada ya siku tatu nitafufuka, wale wa Kleopa walikuwa nasikia.
When he told the disciple that I'm gonna die and I'll rise after 3 days, those Kleopas were listening.
Lakini wangawa wanashituka, kwa nini? Ni kitu gani kinapitika?
But they were still surprised with what happened.
Hawakuwa na ufahamu wa neno la Mungu.
They didn't have knowledge of the word of God.
Mungu anapenda tuwe na ufahamu wa neno lake tunapolisikia.
God wants us to have the knowledge of the word of God when we hear it. We should not have the knowledge of what is happening in the world.
Neno la pili Yesu alilolisema.
The second word that Jesus said.
Ni ambao wenye kuwa na mioyo mizito katika kuamini.
Those who had the slow heart of believing.
Mzito katika kuamini.
Slow heart in believing.
Mtu anaweza kuwa na moyo mwepesi katika kuamini.
Some people can have the like a sharp heart to believe.
Moyo unakuwa mwepesi kwa kutaka vitu vya dunia.
And somehow we have a sharp heart to want stuff from world.
Vitu vya kiroho ama vitu neno la Mungu, mioyo yetu ni mizito.
But in spiritual things our heart are very slow.
Watu wengine huko kanisani wanasikia neno la Mungu wao wanachukua lile mbaya. Asema unisikie.
Some people are in church but they just take the bad words.
Kwa nini alisema vile?
Why did he say that grass?
Maneno mengine yote yeye hakukamata hata
kitu. The other way they didn't keep anything. But only the bad thing is what is speaking up.
Uko mzito katika kuamini.
That means you are slow in believing.
Unakuwa na moyo mzito katika kuamini.
You shouldn't have a slow heart in believing.
Kuamini pasipo kuona.
That's because the Bible says believing without seeing is better in the
travel.
So we should pray God to give us a sharp heart to believe. So we don't believe in lies. We should not believe in lies. In obscene or profanities. A false information. They believe in those. But to believe in the word of God, they don't believe. So here with all sadness, I left one word there.
Wakati wa huzuni ni wakati mkubwa sana mzito.
So the time of sadness is a very difficult time.
Wakati mwenzako anapokuwa katika hali katika huzuni.
When your friend is in sadness,
ni vizuri umsaidie kiroho.
It's important to help him spiritually.
Mtu wa kumchokoza sana.
You should not provoke him.
Msaidie kila kitu kinaweza yani kuondoa ile huzuni wake.
You should help him with something that can take the sadness away. That's why Jesus said gentle because he knew Cleopas was in very sadness. And asked him, what happened? That's why Cleopas started
talking.
You should know that your friend is sad. So how he can approach him? But not if your friend is in sadness and you start provoking him.
Kwa hiyo ile ndio Mungu anapenda kwetu tusaidie walio katika huzuni.
So that's what God wants from us to help those who are in sadness.
Watu katika kuzungumza sasa Yesu anasema.
So during the accommodation Jesus said
usiku ukaingia.
And the night came.
Tusome pale 29 na zaidi.
Let's read from verse
29.
They came near the village to which they were going.
Wakienda naye alifanya kama anataka kuendelea mbele, wakamshawishi wakisema, kaa pamoja nasi kwa kuwa kumekuchwa na mchana umekwisha. Akaingia ndani kukaa pamoja nao.
So he went with them to sit with them.
Hapo ndo tutamalizia.
So we're going to stop about there.
Nilijaribu kupekua Biblia kama 3-4.
So I tried to go around 3 or 4 Bibles.
Niangalie zinasema nini.
To see what they say about those things.
Na ina maana gani?
And what's the really meaning?
Biblia ya Kongo inasema hivi.
Congolese Bible say
Biblia Tanzania ndio tunasoma hapa.
The one we are reading is a Tanzanian Bible.
Nasema wakamshawishi.
And says as he convinced him.
Wangu nanifuata neno moja tu. Wale wakamshawishi Yesu.
So they convinced Jesus.
Usiku umeingia.
The night is coming.
Kaa nasi.
Stay with us.
Twende Biblia ya Kongo.
Let's go to the Congolese Bible.
Biblia ya Kongo inasema.
The Congolese Bible says.
Wakamshurutisha.
So they obliged him.
Wakamshurutisha.
They obliged him.
Usiku umeingia.
The night is coming.
Kaa nasi.
Stay with us.
Twende Biblia ingine.
Let's go to the other Bible.
Biblia ya Wabembe.
Bembe Bible.
Inasema.
Says.
Shie taba na mlombelela.
So they asked him.
Ola la mchumbe neto.
Please come sleep with us.
Chumba leo elela.
Because the sun has gone.
Na busuku wao wina.
And the night is coming.
Imotendika mbole mchiku. Useme lini tunenda. Ile wakamshurutisha.
So we are talking about they obliged him.
Wakamshawishi.
They convinced him.
Bana mlombelela.
They pleased him.
Twende Biblia kifaransa.
Let's go to the French Bible.
Sasa una Biblia pale kifaransa?
The French Bible.
Twende Biblia kifaransa.
C'est Luc 24.
24. Tusikilize kifaransa inasema nini. Ili ndio neno letu la mwisho tuli.
That will be our last word of today. So we're going to describe it to see how we can be close to Jesus. Luke 24, 19, jusqu'au 50e verset.
24, 29.
Le pressèrent en disant
okay.
Reste avec nous car le soir approche les jours ainsi sont des clairs.
Amen.
Amen.
Il lui pressait.
So they pressurized him
en disant
in saying
attends quelle côte.
We don't go all day.
Tunaenda tu ili lui pressait.
We only say about they pressurized him. So let's look at the translations of those four Bibles. So we are trying to find a way how we can stay with Jesus. So the three Bibles give us very wonderful things. The first Bible says they convinced him to convince someone. Is to give him some explanation to make him abide by your thoughts. That means you are trying to convince him, you are trying to urge him so he can abide by your thoughts. Stay with us. Because it's almost night. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That means to attack someone. To attack someone with your own words. To attack Jesus with your words. To convince Jesus to stay with you. They convinced him. That's Tanzanian Bible. Congolese Bible says they obliged him. To God is to require someone.
Je, nini wana wa Mungu mjue kuna maombi ya yani kulazimisha Mungu.
So you are the people of God. Don't you know that there's some prayer to oblige God?
Kuna maombi ya kumlazimisha Mungu.
There's some prayer to oblige God.
Ile maombi.
Those prayers.
Ukiyaomba katika roho na kweli.
If you pray them in spirit and
Mungu
truth.
Anatenda.
So God act.
Si mwana kwa watoto wetu.
You can observe from your children. If your kid wants you to do something for him or her, you can try to escape him. But he obliged you. So he obliged you to do that thing. Praise
Lord.
One day, himself and his wife, they went to Kogan. It's like 1 or 2 weeks ago. So the king talked about kind of food that we don't know. So that kid asked the man that, do you have some money so we can buy this food? And I asked it, oh, can we find that food in Kroger? No, he said, no, it is in McDonald's. So because we were going to Kroger, when we reached there, we told to that kid that you want us to go to McDonald's. Do you see how the line is very long? So let's go to Kroger. Wednesday, we came out from Kroger. So that kid asked the man that, oh, I want to go to McDonald's. So the man said, no, don't you hear what the guy is saying? We have a lot of cars where they are waiting. And that kid said again. So I said, oh, I'm not going to eat anything at home because I miss. So he or she obliged us to go to the McDonald's. And I do the U-turn after the McDonald's. And the his mama asking, where are we going? And the answer, don't you hear what your kid is talking? What are you talking about? Don't you see the line? So that kid obliged us to go there. There's some things that you can oblige God and God can hear. And you can say, Father, I don't like this. It's like our children. They are obliged to Jesus. And Jesus accepted to get with them the house. And the Bible says, they prayed him. They prayed to him. That means something that is coming from humbleness. Please stay with us. Because it's almost night. So because are you praying to Jesus? That means you are asking with pity. In times of your problems and trouble, you go to Jesus and say, oh, Jesus, please stay with me. Praise the Lord. So you should appeal to Jesus, and Jesus will be with you. If you pray to Jesus, he won't let you alone. Because you are showing some humbleness and you're asking him with all the humbleness. So let's finish with French Bible. The French Bible says, so the Bible, the French Bible says that they pressurized Jesus. Yes, that is the third person of plural. They. That means Cleopas and his friends. Pressurized. Let's take the words to put pressure on something. To pressurize something.
Inasema ya kwamba s'appuyer sur, yani
to pressurize is to lean on something.
Appuyer fortement.
That means you are leaning heavily to someone. So those who know French, I'm going to talk a little bit French.
Appuyer fortement.
That means to lean heavily to on something.
Appuyer fortement.
To lean. That means you are leaning like this. So you lean like this. Stay with me. That's A.
B says.
That means to hold him in your hands, to put him on your chest,
Il a pressé dans ses bras.
That means he leaned him in his hands.
Contre sur sa poitrine.
That means against his chest.
Yani, unamweka, yani, walimkamata Yesu kama vile mama anakamata mtoto.
That means they leaned to Jesus that like a mother can lean to a baby. That means they keep him like a mom can hold a baby because it was almost night. Praise Lord. So if we can hold Jesus like our father because it is almost night, that means Jesus won't go away from you. Because there is a mom and a kid. A mom and a kid. If it is an accident, that mom is going to die with her baby. If it is in the sea, that mom will die with her baby. Whenever an accident happens, the mom will die with her baby. So keep Jesus in your hands. So pray to us all. I don't want you to go away from me. Please, wherever you go, please come sit with me. Because it's almost night. Those are demons that would like to destroy the world. We should keep your feet and stand for the word of God.
Ni vizuri ambatie Yesu, amusi Yesu asitoke.
So every Christian is better that you hold Jesus so he doesn't move away from you. What if there is a country that can happen to you? If it is in problems, maybe you are afraid, maybe you are worried about something. If you keep following Jesus and say it's almost night, stay with me. You will reach in the sunrise. There is a prayer member that saying, we are in the night of the church. I will say it in Kibembe. And I will translate. And if it says, when is coming night? And the scraps are coming up. When it's coming night? Everything is happening. The scraps. The snakes, witchcraft, those old stuff breaking night. It's a bad time. That's the time we have the church. That's why you are seeing a lot of stuff happening like vaccination because we are getting night. So you are required to please Jesus to stay with you. So we can see the morning that is coming. If you don't stay with Jesus, so I'm doing this night with Jesus, you won't see the day. And Jesus will come and remain. Don't keep it easy. You should keep hold of Jesus. So you should grab Jesus just like a man can grab his baby. And say, Jesus, stay with me because we are night. And you will overcome everything. May God bless you. So please ask for Jesus to stay with you. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Praise Lord.
Kwa leo nina furaha.